Welcome back. We're here at the New London Gallery, and joining me now is Isa Rex with the Kearsarge Chorale. Thanks for joining us.
Glad to be here.
You have lots of news from the Kearsarge Chorale this spring.
We do. We are going through a transition process. Our artistic director, David Amond, who started the group in 2008, has decided that he needs to pursue other musical areas of interest, primarily composition, which has been a big interest of his for a long time. And of course, he is organist at St. Andrews and choir master also there. So his plate is pretty full.
I'll say, yeah, that composing just is not something you'd pick up and do in 5 minutes.
Exactly, and that's what he will tell you.
So. Right, right. But good for him, great reasons that he's moving on to all this
terrific
work.
And it will be an adjustment for the chorale, no doubt. But at the moment, we have several extremely well-qualified candidates who've expressed an interest in the position. And we'll be meeting with them over the next few months. And we're all hopeful that we'll have some sort of positive announcement down the road, not too long of a time.
Okay, so that search is still open. If we have any people qualified in the audience, they could still contact the chorale. Very good. Okay, good. Well, let's talk about the spring concert coming up.
Yes, well, this is a very exciting concert for us. The actual title of the concert is Dear People, Celebrating the Centenary of Robert Shaw. Now, Robert Shaw was essentially the reinventor of American choral music, and towards the end of his life, he was considered to be the elder statesman of American musical performance. Actually, we're missing his birthday by about a week because he was born April 30th, 1916, but it's pretty close altogether. And so many of the pieces that we'll be performing are arrangements of familiar tunes, hymns, and spirituals that he collaborated with Alice Parker in writing. And Alice Parker actually deserves a note here. She was born in 1925, is a graduate of Smith College and the Juilliard School, and she studied with Robert Shaw in choral conducting, which is how that whole collaboration began. And she is still actively composing in her 90s, and she is going to be doing a workshop the following week up here. So that's very exciting.
That's terrific. I'll say that's amazing that she's still active. Good for her.
Yes, well, it's a great lesson for all of us, I think, right?
Keep moving.
That's right.
Right, right.
And I should also mention that the Chamber Singers, which is the smaller group in the chorale, will be doing Bach's Cantata number 4. And this is particularly germane to a program about Robert Shaw because Robert Shaw devoted himself to and immersed himself in Bach's music. So it's entirely fitting.
Neat. We were talking a little bit off camera. You said there's a little wardrobe change that we can all anticipate.
Well, yes. We decided after a number of years of wearing all black that especially in the spring, it would be nice to brighten things up a little bit. So the board voted that the women should wear jewel-toned tops.
Beautiful.
And of course the men will still be wearing their suits and bow ties, but so we'll see how that goes.
Oh, it'll be gorgeous. Well, good. Well, we're actually taping the show here at YCN. We're taping the concert and it will be broadcast. So from a TV point of view, I think that sounds wonderful.
Well, good. We made the right decision.
And you always sound great. So that will be wonderful.
Well,
so
you.
Good. So we've got your website up on the screen. Best way to get tickets.
Well, actually, we do not charge admission. We do ask for a donation.
Wonderful.
And for people who would like to contribute, and that is great.
Right, to keep the music coming. Well, very good. We look forward to the show in April. Best wishes for a nice spring.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Isa.
Okay.